Hey guys, JJ here, and some new details regarding the Resident Evil 3 remake have been revealed via the official PlayStation UK magazine. So with that being said, let's get right into it. Today we got some new insight into the Resident Evil 3 remake thanks to an interview in PlayStation UK's magazine. Some of this news is very good and reassuring, but unfortunately it's not all positive. I'll start with the good news. Nemesis will use a new and improved version of the artificial intelligence that was developed for Mr. X in the Resident Evil 2 remake. We all know that Mr. X became much more menacing in the remake and shared a lot of characteristics very similar to the Nemesis. The only difference being that the Nemesis can go into a full sprint at the character and carries a rocket launcher. So I'm definitely interested to see how Capcom will bring these characteristics back with their new AI. Next up, Capcom understands that sound is very important in Raccoon City and will play a big role in the remake. Now, the player will have to rely on the sounds around them to anticipate dangers that lie around every corner. I'm all for immersion myself, so it's reassuring to know that Capcom understands how important something like sound is to a game. Next up is a big one. Capcom has confirmed that iconic locations set in Raccoon City will return, such as the streets, obviously, shops, the Stagla patrol station, Raccoon press offices, and the hospital. One thing that was very important to the original RE3 was that the streets felt alive. They were a maze that had death. Having these different locations for the player to explore offered consistent changes to the scenery that created some very memorable locations. I'm very glad to hear that they will return. Next up is that the mutant worms will return once again. This is good news, but I really hope that all the enemies from the original will return in some capacity. Capcom had made the choice to cut some of the enemies in the RE2 remake, and I hope that isn't the case with RE3. We better get the Gravedigger. And last bit of good news is that Carlos will be playable once again. The original Resident Evil 3 didn't offer two scenarios like the first and second game, but it did have a section for Carlos, which was a good change of pace. I don't want to spoil it for those that haven't played, but I really hope Capcom expands on his part a little bit more. Now we get into the not so good news. Don't expect a lot of exploration in Raccoon City, like in an open world game, but there will still be plenty of exploration in many areas of the city. This one's not too big of a deal because I wasn't really expecting or want an open world game for RE3, but I do hope that the city is expanded on from the original. The choice system that was first introduced in the original Resident Evil 3 will no longer be returning in the remake. This is very unfortunate because I felt that allowing the player to make quick choices that had an effect on the story was a good way to add replayability, which is what classic Resident Evil games are known for. That leads us into our next bit of news. There will only be one ending. This may be good news for some of the fans that want consistency in the lore, but again, for me, this removes a huge portion of replayability. Not a good move. Last but not least, to add salt to the wound, my favorite bonus mode in all of the Resident Evil games, Mercenaries mode, will no longer return in the Resident Evil 3 remake. Capcom has stated that Resistance will be bundled with the game, so I'm assuming that it will take Mercenaries' place. I really hope that Mercenaries returns somehow, some way, possibly in future DLC. I have no idea, but it's really unfortunate to hear. So there you have it. All the things that will return, be improved or changed. Be that for better or worse. This news was a really mixed bag for me. Sure, I'm glad to see certain aspects of the game are returning, but a lot of that is to be expected, right? The features that will not return, however, are kind of a big deal, at least to me. But I'm curious to know your thoughts. What are you excited to see return? How do you feel about losing the choice system? Are you okay with just one ending? What do you think about Mercenaries being cut? Let us know down in the comments and let's discuss it. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and subscribe for all the latest Resident Evil 3 news. The Residents of Evil is a Patreon-supported channel, so if you'd like to help support the channel and unlock some great perks in return, head over to patreon.com/RoneNetwork. As always, thank you guys so much for watching, and we hope to see you back at the Residents of Evil.